Hi, good afternoon. Can you please give me your name?
My name is Myrna Manzanares. Just a photo, my name. My name is Myrna Manzanares. It's an honor, that's an English, right?
Great. Hi, Ms. Myrna. Can you give me a brief background on what you do?
Alright, in the first instance, I am an educator. I'm a counselor, educator, community clinical. But that is just the... That is just what I studied and about coming about. Me, the Myrna Manzanares, I'm an international storyteller. I am a community-oriented person. I like to work in the community and I like to work with people, right? I had a farm malanti. Case would never know that. That's one of the nicest village when I really grew up, right? So I had a farm malanti and I am quite happy to be from Malanti, no matter where Una Man is or Una Man is ever
with me. Okay, thank you. You are here at the Creole Council. What is your role, what is the role that you play here?
Alright, the National Creole Council, let me tell you a little bit about that, has been around from 1995. And our main objective, what we want to do, we want to make sure that our Creole children and our Creole family, they understand their culture, right? We want to know that there is a Creole culture because, you know, people like say Creole no got no culture. Remember when the Lamar everyone said, I want to who say Creole no got no culture. And we know Creole got culture, but they don't know. And so what we wanted to make sure that they understand what the culture is, they understand all of the different things that we do within that culture, and they understand that we are people and we smart, because I tell you, in our family, we are smart and we mix, because you know, who are the people that will come from Malanti? First Chief Justice, Belizean in this country. So I just to try make it a new, right? Alright. So, but at the Creole Council, I just want to give you a backlog, it was established. I was the president for about 10 years. And then it was tiring being the president. So I wanted to move on. I really actually wanted to be the cultural person. So at this point in time, I am the cultural ambassador. The cultural attaché of the National Creole Council.
Wow, that's great. Miss Myrna, can you now give me a background on the Creole culture itself? Like the values, the tradition itself.
Alright. The Creole culture. We go way, way back. I like to say we are the indigenous group of Belize. And when I say that, the Mayas are indigenous of the region, but Belize itself, that Creole men there, and how the Creole get there, you had the British, right? And they never have no white woman here. And they brought all of the female slaves, so you know what that will happen when they do with the female slaves. And they have children, and it is those children of the white man and the black woman, the European, the English, and the African. That is, the children of that became the Creole. And those Creole people were born right here in Belize. They were born no place else, right? They were born right here in Belize. So for me, they're indigenous, right? And what happened during that period, you have certain times when people run away. And some people run away and some people get caught. Somebody in Ghana, Nicaragua. And the group that went to Gates Point, they ran away, and you know where they call Runaway Creek? You see Runaway Creek when they're going to Gates Point? Well, that was a very important area. That is the area where they would run and hide. You understand me? And eventually they move until they move to Malanti. You know Gates Point, Malanti, they move down to Malanti. And once they get there, they set up, you know, they start to work along the river of then what did Malanti proper, they go to pass Sunday, the peninsula. But during the weekend there, what they place in the man when they Kwamina Creek, they don't Kwamina Creek, but one of the places where they against the bank of the river, that's where they used to stick and they used to fish and farm and everything. You know? and the weekend they go in at the village, and that's how the Africans get there. And that's how when we come to Belize City, now I say this because I'm vexed and I don't want nobody say it, and nobody cuss me about it. When I got, when I came from Malante, I'm going to Belize City Ghana school, you know what they call me? Malante black boy. And I still vexed to this day, somebody still want to think they're better than me, right? They tell me Malante black boy. But all of them come from this show them. Yeah, I want to call them. And the reason why they tell me we're a little bit darker than all the others, right? But those of us, when they cut Malante black boy, we show them we may be black boy, but we excel. Like Sir George, you know, we had lawyers from down there, we had educators, we had nurses, I mean, you know. So, hey, but that was, and that's the reason why the Creole people, we are the Creoles, and that's the reason why they used to call us, like I said, the man of the black people. We were darker, we were Africans, our ancestors were Africans, and the things we did in our village, a lot of it was African, we cook power with fire hot. Why, I mean, look at the cafe, something. You ever eat Johnny cake from fire hot? You don't ever eat rice and beans and all of them things on fire hot when you cook that guy? Damn, I tell you they're nice. You understand me? So we had all of them good food down the tomato and put the meat and all of them things. They were nice. Right? And your serai and your kung fu. Oh boy, anyway, let them go on and come and start to get money. But seriously, we had good food, we had a lot of things, and not that good games. Not that kind of thing. I don't know if you want to ask me anything else.
Alright, as we go into that, I would like to ask you, what are some of the superstitions and beliefs of the Creole culture?
Well, look at that we got, right? I know you're going over here about old head. You want to know here about old head? You guys want to go Caribbean history? And they hear about old head from Trinidad? But the Belize, the Malante, you know, talk about old head. This is our lady. And this lady, she used to change the night. Turn into a big bird that night. Yes. And they say she used to suck people blood. And like a vampire, but they don't like a vampire. They say that evening they have a martyr. We don't know where a martyr. We don't know what the martyr. Yes. They have a martyr. And they take the martyr that evening and they get front of the skin that evening time. He get front of the skin and he woke up your hand so, right? He get front of the skin. And then he take a beat and he go down. He don't want to do it. You don't got a beat yet. He stand up front of the matter. And he can't do anything there. Why? And he take off his skin and he take out of that skin. And he step out of that skin. And when he take that skin out, so he take that skin. And he put it in the matter. And he cover up the matter and put it right aside. I do. Oh yes, so that when he come back in later on, you want it right there. And when she get out of that skin, she fly all over the place to look free. Whatever it is, people don't where you're going for. No. It's a little bonus. Not very bad people. And they all look up. Find out if they did a true thing or whatever. But it might be fun. And people. And they see when they come out and see it. Then the mother and cover up the mother. So when she fly down, they tell her you have to take warm glove or salt. Put salt on the skin so that night they die. Put a lot of salt. behind my tree, and the nightmare that will come back. He bent down to get the skin, and he couldn't get in his skin. So they put in a skin. He says, skinny, 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 you don't know me, skinny, skinny, you don't know me. Kini, 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 you know me? You don't know me? You don't know me? Kini, 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 you don't know me? Kini, kini, you don't know me? His skin never know him. And so she couldn't get in his tag, a lot of sand. So she, I wonder, and she bend down and pick up his skin. And he got way in the back. Way in the back. Drop his skin. Nobody never say it again. But you know what they do with the skin? They dig one hole and they bury the skin so that you know, and they put rock salt on it. And that's the way my skin is there. Yes. That's one of the things they wear lamps and I leave and tell me. One of them, you know, I know that too. Another thing that I was telling about, my mom tell me, Ramalante. The Belize, nobody know member Tatadwende. There's a book that Miss Lady, which she have in Tatadwende and all of the folklore. And they have Tatadwende, which is a Maya mestizo. Right? It's a little short man with a big hat. Nobody can remember the Creole culture. But the Maya mestizo, the least short man with a big hat, and yes, he also in a big. He also in the forest, and they say, for we, Tataduhende, you know, a tall, black, hairy man, and when you see him, you better do so, and you do so. Can you know what happened if you do so? You don't know what happened? They will cut off your finger, because this man only got four fingers, and you know, they in the forest, in the woods. And if you get trouble, the man, if you go get trouble, your parents are like, tell them, send her right at Tatadwende, you'll be afraid. And you don't want to go to Tatadwende. You don't want to go to Tatadwende. So, you're afraid for Tatadwende. You know? And then when they come to spirit and soul, they used to say, people that die walk the earth. So we always have to be afraid for spirit. And I could tell you one thing when it happened. One thing I'm with my cousin Fred, every 19 day old, and they tell him, boy, come in here. Boy, come in on time, chop. And they all over the place. And one 19 day come up here. And when he look, he see a big bunch of rumble, the road behind him. He stopped, the rumble stopped. He continued to walk, the rumble, the road behind him. Now he get frightened. He start to walk fast. They rumble the road fast. Oh, he really, really frightened. So he stopped. The rumble stopped. And then he came up to me and he run as fast as he could run. And by the time he get home, he just left the door. By the time he get home, he run up the step, open the door, slam the door, and lean upside of the door. And in a 2 minutes, he hear a blam! Side of the door. A big bunch of rumble just come on the knock side of the door. And that, you know what happens to you? And everybody believe that the dead from Kowanyo and all of that. But anyway, that is some of the things that women get a man to do. And in the Creole culture, everywhere they have different things. My experience that deals point, right? And so I learned things then from down there.
Going up, what was like a day practice for the Creole culture? Going up as a child, what are some things that you guys would do when you get up in the morning? Do you go back home at night?
Well, you know, usually when you're a child, you get up, you have to go out and necessarily wash your feet and all of that, right? And you make your work. You have to clean down the step, or you have to do this for a hundred. But then the parents end up fixing breakfast, then I'm telling kids, right, Jack, they got Creole ready, right? And then you go to school, and I come back 12 o'clock to walk, and you get your food ready and everything, right? Now, after school, the evening when I come after school, that's the way we have fun, that's the way the game starts. Because we used to play all kind of games. Rock Macachista, when you know about Rock Macachista, and when you rock Macachista the wrong way. When you was broke Macachista, we go around the circle. One is lady out there ring, one is lady out there ring, one is lady out there ring. Open that hip and let them in. Put your hand on your hip, front of the next person. And you broke Macachista. Broke Macachista, broke it back, broke Macachista, broke it back. You pick them and they say, broke Macachista. That also, you know, you go that side and you go that side, right? One you go that side and one you go that side. That's where you do broke Macachista. And then that was fun, boy and girl play. Then we had outside Jubel. Outside Jubel, to the window, outside Jubel, to the window, outside Jubel, to the window, tra la 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 la. Then inside Jubel, to the window, and you come inside around in a circle. Then you got your face to partner. Then you hold my hand and you say, then rise Jubel, to the window, rise Jubel, to the window, rise Jubel, to the window, tra la 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 la. Then shakalaka Jubel, to the window, shakalaka Jubel, to the window, shakalaka Jubel, to the window, tra la 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 la. Then you dance, and after you don't dance, you wheel, that is the fun part. And you hold the hand especially and you wheel. Boy, you know that wheeling is good for the brain. You never even know that, but then you wheel and that was fun. That was another game you have on. We have a book right here called Traditional Games, you know? We had games like Lyman Spoon, you know, I know Lyman Spoon. And we had the bicycle wheel. Take off the wheel in the metal part, and we used to knock it down the street so. And then we hold it and they go all kind of way. But we never need all of it. A lot of things we didn't have today. All kind of different things. And I show you because some of them, the writing of them. The good one of them, like the leaf picnic, that was Miss Jennery Jones. I've come to see Miss Jennery Jones, Miss Jennery Jones, Miss Jennery Jones. Come to see Miss Jennery Jones. How are you today? But that one when they show up, Miss Jennery Jones is washing, is ironing. Some of the kids when they smile, they know the most friends.
Okay, and I know this last question that I will ask you is probably a lot of things. So, can you tell me a little about the celebrations? That you guys, the functions that you guys have mainly around Christmas, Easter.
Right, but that, you know, that one that I like. There are two very big celebrations. Number one is the Sambai, and number two is Christmas. Let me tell you about the Sambai. The Sambai is one fertility dance, right? And it usually was done during the time, the full moon, because the full moon is set up all over the moon, and you get pregnant in time. But it's also the time when time. They plant, right? That is the planting season. And the sambai, it's a dance around in a circle, in the middle is a fire, and the people dance around the sambai, around the fire. And the movements are very sexual, and the songs are very, very sexual as well, you know? And our children were not allowed to dance when I was there, okay? I drove sambai when I was a big woman, right? And so I have just shown you some of the steps to the samba. And some of the songs, like for example, one of the songs then, when I'm gone for water, I see one man so hairy, hairy foot, sambo, where you think I yonder? If he foot so hairy, then where you think I yonder? Hairy foot, sambo, where you think I yonder? And the movements, the girls will hold their skirt. Boy, then they dance with their foot back. Da, 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 da. And then when they get to the partner, you know, when they dance, like for example, when I'm down to water, I see one with some theory. You put some room where you think I am. Now, when you get to your partner, this is what you do. You put some room where you think I am, right? They just do that, your body just heave, right? That's how they do it, the sambai. And everybody, the men jump and they go on it. make the men go like this, and they're picking the girl, right? And then the other one is the samba, is the brown, that's at the Christmas. During the Christmas, you're brown, right? You're brown. During the Christmas, you're brown. And when you're brown, everybody, they dance. My name is Lily, how are you this morning? Up to Raja come in and a very Christmas morning. And she had one baby, I lay in a high ground. Baby was passing and meeting a valley boom boom. Paddle pan table, grand tap, paddle pan table. My name is Lily, how are you this morning? Up to Raja come in and a very Christmas morning. And she had one baby, I lay in a high ground. Baby was passing and meeting a valley boom boom. Paddle pan table, grand tap, paddle pan table. Traditionally, that's the way you end any breakdown song with that bararam bum hum. Alright? And the Brahmin with the Brahmin, I will tell you. Oi! And your Brahm, and your Brahm, and your dance. Alright? Brahm, you're hanging in the air. And your foot on the ground, and the dance, and the dance. Alright? Good morning, Miss Lady. How are you this morning? Come to Raja complain on this Merry Christmas morning. And I see you want baby, high in a high grass. Baby was passing and he stayed up and from everybody they dance, right? But that is the reason why they stop in a people's house. Because they was going in a people's house. And one of the hosts over there gone, he knock out the whole bottom of the floor. Yes, I see my brother, I don't know if she and me, but she never did it, but knock out the whole bottom of the damn floor. So they no brum in a people house anymore. Everybody go from house to house and they brum in front of the house. Yes, that's a good time. That time, you go, you sing fellowship, you go, you visit every house, and they sing all the songs. And now some of the religions are coming in, and you don't want them to dance brum. Because they think that they will worship all kind of thing. So we want to keep our culture. That is a part of our culture. So we don't want nobody to tell us how to celebrate our cultural traditions.
So when it down me, the dumb skin down.
David him. Your brother David sing. Hey boy da mochula, somebody da mochula. Hey, on the corner right here. Part of the circle. Hey boy da mochula, somebody da mochula. Hey mochula, somebody da mochula. Hey boy da mochula, somebody da mochula. Hey mochula. Yeah, you notice that the older people used to dance differently, right? The young people are, bam! You see how she did that just now? Totally different. But everything is just like anything else, right? But that was the samba, and then the brum is at Christmas time. The brum, everybody go from host to host. All over Belize they used to do that. Only the Creole people, the Garifuna people used to follow them, and they used to do the Jankuno as well. So we would go all over and we would do the brum, and we would